Today we are testing out some Milwaukee impact wrenches to see which stubby is right for you. What's up everyone, I'm Nick with Ohio Power Tool, and today we are going to test and compare Milwaukee M18 FUEL impact wrenches. We're going to use a Skidmore machine for testing. What's a Skidmore, you ask? Well, it's Wilhelm's hydraulic tension calibrator, or bolt tension calibrator, and has been the industry standard for testing high strength bolts since it was invented in the 1950s. I honestly don't know, I just googled it and that's what it said. But I do know that we're going to use it to match some of the Milwaukee fastener ratings and how they perform using the different models. So let's get started! Now, calibrations on the Skidmore machines may vary. For this test, we use M18 6.0 batteries for each tool. First up, the Milwaukee M18 half-inch compact impact wrench with the friction ring, the 2855-20. This compact impact is the smallest of the M18s we are testing today. We're getting a reading of just about 20,000, which is really good performance for such a small design. Compacts like these are good for standard day-to-day use and tight jobs where there might be a little less space. Next up, we have the Milwaukee M18 half-inch mid-torque impact wrench with pin detent, the 2962P-20. When we attach this to our Skidmore machine, we got a reading of just about 28,000. That's about a 40% increase in fastening power from the compact. And the size is pretty comparable to the compact, so you can still hit the tighter spaces with a little extra oomph. Onto the Milwaukee M18 half-inch extended anvil controlled torque impact wrench with one key, the 2769-20. These guys are extended anvil controlled torque impacts and are a great option for tire technicians, as you can eliminate the hassle of the hoses and still get up to 1100 pounds of torque. You know, you can even customize the level of torque with the handy dandy torque adjuster right on the tool. This is great for vehicle applications, from small cars and bikes to box trucks and larger vehicles. When we threw it on the Skidmore, we got a reading of just about 34,000, so about a 20% increase from the mid-torque and a 70% jump from the compact in fastening power. But that's why it's high torque. Duh. Last but not least, the Milwaukee M18 1-inch D-handle high torque impact wrench with one key, the 2868-20. Just like COVID, this was released in 2020. This powerhouse, when attached to the Skidmore, got a reading of just about 65,000. That is 91% above the high torque, 132% above the mid, and a massive 225% above the compact. Great for rail workers, iron work, utility work, and large mechanical applications. So that's the gist of the Skidmore comparisons. But wait, there's more. We didn't talk about friction ring versus pin detent. Detent. So a friction ring is a rubber ring that helps keep the socket seated to the square base. Now this is useful for applications where you are needing to quickly get a socket on and off. This is primarily used for a lot of horizontal applications, such as taking off lugs or tightening something from the side. The rubber has some flexibility, so it's a little looser, which makes it easy for removal or change out of different heads. The pin detent, on the other hand, is a spring-loaded pin that holds the socket on the driver. When you are attaching the socket to the driver, there is a small indentation or groove that you can attach into for a firm, solid grip. Now, this is a tighter hold than the friction ring and is often used on applications where speed of changeout is not the primary focus, but it will help prevent the socket from falling off when you're using the tool. It's great for overhead, vertical applications, or to help prevent a bit from falling and hitting you. Milwaukee also offers their impacts with one key, so you can track, manage, and customize your tools, as well as organize your data for them all in one place. So that's it for today. Shoot us a comment if you have anything you'd like to see. Like and subscribe for more content, and we will see you next time.